Here we are in sunny San Jose at Superstars Game Center. There's a PTQ going on next door, but I have captured one of the players who doesn't need to play in the PTQ. Once again, Luis Scott-Vargas. How's it going, Luis?
Good. I wish I could play in the PTQ in the sense that I like PTQs, not...
In the sense that you like to crush dreams?
Not in the sense that I wish I was unqualified.
Well, in the sense that you like to send poor young children home crying because Luis crushes them again, huh?
I miss being able to play in PTQs.
They are fun. They're always an event. You know, you always get that core set of regulars. The one drawback is it's all for one seat, and you can sit there all day.
It's a winner-take-all tournament. One of the local guys, Matt Nass, just lost back-to-back PTQs in the finals.
Yeah, coming in second twice.
As much as people congratulate him on making the finals twice, it feels pretty bad to lose in the finals. I would imagine. I mean,
definitely. Oh, yeah. Really?
Really? Yeah.
Do you know anything about losing in the finals,
Luis? Yeah.
Speaking of PTQs and Pro Tours, we have Honolulu coming up, a block tournament. Kind of odd because there's no block season for the PTQ. Non-professional competitive Magic players.
Yeah, but people are going to follow it, and it's a popular format on Magic Online. Block's always great, especially since Lauren Block, well, it had too many fairies in it, and people didn't like that.
Yeah, that it's terrible because this looks like a great block format. You know, you can play every color, you can play all of them at once.
Yeah.
But I think a lot of people were disheartened, A, by fairies in the last block, and B, there's no real reason to play block this year.
Yeah, like them missing out on Ravnica block 2, which they also didn't have as a format.
Looks like it would have been a great block.
Yeah, so I don't know what the rationale is, but yeah, block's going to be fun.
So right now, as you think ahead towards Honolulu, what are there any cards or what card do you think defines the current block format?
I mean, all of this is obviously without Alara Reborn out.
Of course.
But even with just the two sets, it'll kind of shape how the metagame turns out. Because people, you know, who have been testing now do have a head start. Right now, Elspeth's by far the most dominant card because the aggro decks play it, the control decks play it, the mid-range decks play it. It's just a very powerful effect, and you need yours to kill theirs if you know.
Yeah.
It's pretty hard to kill Elspeth.
At worst, she destroys target Elspeth.
It's really hard to kill Elspeth otherwise.
Yeah. I mean, is she that much better than Ajani and Sarkhan?
Yeah, especially since Elspeth kills other planeswalkers really well, too, because it sends the soldiers, you know,
as
4/4 flyers to go kill Ajani or Sarkhan Vol.
Wow. And so, what's the better strategy as you look at it now? Playing aggro Elspeth or control Elspeth? Or
You can go either way. Like, the most successful decks have been the more aggressive because they generally play less colors. And the thing about block is mana fixing is pretty bad. It's just the tri-lands, really.
Okay.
Like Seaside, Citadel, etc.
You don't rely on the panoramas at all?
No, they're way too slow. So, because it's all tri-lands, if you want to play multiple colors, you need to play a ton of them. Like, some of the five-color control decks play 20 tri-lands and, like, a couple basics.
Wow.
Like, so the aggro decks that play, like, 1 to 3 colors, there's even, like, a mono-white deck.
Uh-huh.
You know, they can avoid playing tri-lands and play mostly basics, and they can curve out a lot better.
So it's just all those come into play tap lands slow you down.
Yeah, they do. I mean, you obviously get access to the most powerful of spells. And one of the spells that actually kind of regains the tempo is Wretched Banquet, because... So, like, you play a tap land, and then they play, like, a 2-drop. You can play another tap land and still kill their guy, just as a way to slow them down in a 5-pillar deck.
How about things like Infest and Fallout? I mean,
Infest is seeing some play. Fallout, not quite as much, just because double red's a little harder. Like, the control decks are more black-based. So, but the problem is a lot of the guys are pretty beefy right now. Like, you've got Woolly Thoktar, Wild Nacatl.
Sure.
Like, Roxwar Monk. I mean... Against the mono white deck Infest is pretty good because they have like Sigil Paladin, Necrozm Squire, you know, Knight of the White Orchid or whatever. But
so are we in a format where Luis Scott-Vargas might actually play aggro, like win by turning creatures sideways?
Well, black white tokens did do that.
I don't know if I'd call that the aggro deck in the format. Though.
Right, it wasn't. I don't know yet. It's possible. I'd like to avoid that, I guess. You know, mystical teachings for life and all that.
True, but. How are islands in this format? I mean, we're talking about Elspeth, we're talking about...
There's not really like a Drago style of deck, both because your land's going to play tapped in, because they've been hosing counter spells, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. People don't really like to play against... when counter spells are too good, people don't have that much fun.
Well, there's just... The interaction like, is like...
Remember fairies with like
counter.
Spellstetter Sprite, Broken Ambitions, Cryptic Command, and Mistpine Click is like a pseudo, like, you know, Time Walk.
Yeah, yeah.
People just didn't get to play their spells, and that doesn't contribute to a good game. So, in block... The counter spells, you've got Cancel, and you've got Counter Squall, and you've got maybe Hindering Light. And so basically, you can't make a counter spell based strategy.
How about Martial Coup in terms of board
That's
triggers?
The other really big one.
Yeah.
Just because It wraths and gives you 5/1/1, so it's a really big tempo boost.
Right. It's your you get to clean them out and win the game, which is your victory right. condition. Right?
And even at less than 7 mana, it still makes a bunch of guys.
Sure.
It's particularly good with something like Garruk, even though most people don't really play. Well,
no, Sarkhan.
Not in block Garruk okay. is gonna. There's been type 2 decks playing Garruk Wildspeaker.
Oh so. Yeah, there was a green white token
that made
right?
top 8 at the Star City
right,
Games
right,
tournament.
Right.
That's pretty good because you Garruk, Martial Coup, the next turn overrun, but. In block, mostly just ramping up to 7. Knight of the White Orchid helps.
Sure. How about you mentioned Wretched Banquet in terms of spot removal. What about Path to Exile?
No, that's played all over the place.
It's
also.
Just everywhere, huh?
I mean, it deals with like Woolly Thoktar or whatever, you know, big idiots they've been playing.
How about any Domain deck lists relying on...
Oh, Matka Riders and stuff like yeah. that?
Mana Force Maze, who knows?
Well, not Mana Force Maze. That's not going to be good enough. But Matka Riders is a powerful enough card. I still don't really see that happening too much.
So when, you know, we're still, what, a month out?
Of the set coming out or the
of
Pro Tour?
Pro Tour.
We're like 2 months out of the Pro Tour.
2 months out. So when do you sit down and start playing? I mean, Alara Reborn comes out and immediately just hit the drawing board?
Probably like a week before the Pro Tour, might play a game or two.
Oh, cocky as ever.
No, yeah, once Alara Reborn comes out, definitely going to get some playtesting in. Got Pro Tour, or GP Seattle to worry about, which is a week before Honolulu, but that's standard and... It's a GP, so obviously you're going to devote less time to that, but still, you know, got to win them all.
Got to win everyone, huh? Sounds good. Well, good luck in Honolulu.
Thank you.
And thanks for sneaking back here and giving us your thoughts on Block.
All right, sounds good.
There we go.